Hello and welcome to Sketch Together. My name is Pablo Stanley, and this is part of a series on Photoshop tricks for UI designers that use tools like Sketch or Figma or Adobe XD as their main design tool, but still need to use Photoshop for some quick image adjustments. On this video, we're going to learn how to change a specific color on an image using Color Range Select. Pretty cool. Let's do it. Sometimes you want to change a specific color in a photo, and to do so, you can use a tool called Color Range Selection. Over here on the Select menu, you're going to see a tool that is called Color Range. So just click here on this option, and then here, you are going to be able to select a specific color of your photo. You can go here and select all of the reds, all of the yellows, all of the greens, and so on. You can even go and select skin tones. But you can also select, go over here and say sample colors. By selecting sample colors, you can start sampling colors that you want to select from your photo. Here with the eyedropper, I can just start clicking on the image, just like this. And then see how here it's giving me a preview of how this selection is going to look. So if I play around with the fuzziness, see how it starts selecting a little bit more. My selection starts getting a little bit bigger. So what I want to do is go over here on my eyedropper and say add to sample. So here, the one that has a plus sign, and start clicking on the rest of the image. That way I'm adding more colors to my selection. See how I'm going to here close to the edges. That way I select all of these colors that are part of the background. It's sampling all of these colors. I'm just clicking. And this works great because it's a flat background. It's a flat color. So all I'm doing is just selecting the different shades of this same hue, of this same color. I'm seeing that I'm apparently selecting some of the skin. I'm getting some particles here and over here, but it's okay. We're going to get rid of those in a moment. So I'm over here. I can play around with the fuzziness. See, probably that's too much. Around there is okay. I'm going to get rid of these later. So I'll press okay. And now that I have this selection, I can go ahead here on my adjustment layers, and I'm going to select Hue Saturation. And it created a new hue saturation adjustment layer with the selection that I had selected. So here, now that I have this, I can play around with the hue and see I can change the color of the background. But if you see, I'm also changing part of the skin because the selection is being part of the skin. So what I can do is go here on my selection, on my layers list, and press Alt Option, and then just click here. And now I can see only the selection as black and white, and I can start painting over the parts that I don't want to be part of the selection. So I'm going to press B for my brush tool over here, brush tool, and then I'm going to start painting black all these parts where I don't want my selection to be. So I'm just going to start painting with a soft brush, just like that. Oops, probably that was too much. Just around there. Around here too. All this stuff, I don't want this to be part of my selection, so I'm going to get rid of this. There you go. That's around it. You can go ahead and just like play around with this a little bit more until you get it right. So now I click over here and see, now it got rid of that selection, so it's not affecting the color here on my adjustment layer. So I'm going to zoom out a little bit more, and as you can see, now this is pretty dope. I can just start changing the color until the color that I want. Also here in the hue saturation, I can press on colorize, and that way I can just, it's one single color and one single hue that is just being applied to my selection. And I can play around with the saturation. I can say, let's turn it red or turn it orange, whatever I want. I can just play around with that. Now, if I want to just select also change the color of this rose, what I can do is create a new selection layer. I'm going to turn this off. I'm going to select this photo again. I'm going to go to select color range, and I'm going to start doing the same, but now with the colors here of this flower. So I'm going to press the plus on the eyedropper. I'm going to start selecting all the different colors that are here, around there. I'm going to turn up the fuzziness,
It looks like it's also grabbing some of the colors here because these are also like reddish colors. So I just select all of these. Once I'm ready, I select, I say okay, and then I create a new adjustment layer of hue saturation. There you go. And I'm going to change the hue. As you can see, it's changing some of the colors here. So what I can do is just press Alt here on my selection, and I can just see my selection that I have. So I can start painting on the stuff that I don't want. So I'm going to paint all of this stuff. All of this stuff shouldn't be affected by my selection. All of this stuff. There you go. You can go as deep, as detailed as you want. But for this demonstration, I'm just going to keep it as that. I'm just going to go back to my adjustment layer. As you can see, now I'm changing only the flower. Apparently, there's some stuff that I'm missing, like here. So I can go back here. And now, instead of black, I want to paint white. So I'm going to go here. And I want all of this to be part of my selection. So I can go ahead, just paint all of this stuff. I'm going to make my brush a little bit smaller. All of this should be affected by my adjustment layer. So I'm going to paint all of this. There you go. Just like that, go back here. And I can see that all of this is being affected. I can have a pretty cool, purplish, flower, and I can turn on the other one. There you go. So I'm going to group these just to see it before and after. This is the before and this is the after. Look at that. Pretty cool stuff, right? So this could help you, any photo that you have, and probably you want to adjust the branding color of the shirt. You want to adjust an element in the photo to match a branding color of whatever website that you're working on. You can do so with the color range tool on the select menu. That's it. Hopefully you find this useful, and thank you so much. Bye-bye.